be magnified in this your holy temple, in this your holy place, and we will rise to Zion's heights to praise and glorify, unify. Oh, how we love you. Oh, how we
loved us. We serve God who is defined by love. God doesn't give love. God is love. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believeth in him should not perish, but shall have everlasting life. This is the center of the New Testament gospel, that God loved us, that he sent his Son so that we could be saved Thank God for the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus. Psalms number 31 is a psalm of David, and I will read verses number 19 unto 24. Psalms 31, verse 19. Oh, how great is thy goodness, which thou hast laid up for them that fear thee, which thou hast wrought for them that trust in thee before the sons of men. Thou shalt hide them in the secret of thy presence from the pride of man. Thou shalt keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues. Blessed be the Lord, for he hath showed me his marvelous kindness in a strong city. For I said in my haste, I am cut off from before thine eyes. Nevertheless, thou heardest the voice of my supplications when I cried unto thee. O love the Lord, all ye his saints, for the Lord preserveth the faithful and plentifully rewardeth the proud doer. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. All ye that hope in the Lord. This division of the psalm is sung by David. David sung and wrote as a warrior. He knew how to touch God through his worship. David was so troubled that he begins to explain in detail the impact of the stress, the grief, and the agony that he was going through. And it's powerful because many of us can relate to David in various circumstances, even now, with what's happening in the world and on this earth. It causes sorrow and grief. David begins to describe his agony, and he goes on to describe how the pain is starting to affect his eyes. His eyes started to go. David, as a warrior and as a soldier, is not ashamed to talk about the pain that he's feeling. And as much as David is going through this agony, he doesn't necessarily blame others for what he's going through. Because he says in an earlier verse, because of his iniquity, because of the sin that was inherent in him. And he doesn't specify what particular sin that he's referring to. It could be just inherent sin on the whole. But we know the life of David. As much as David loved God, as much as David had a heart after God, he struggled with this inherent sin that we all don't like to talk about, and we don't like to confess and admit that as much as we're saved, we're still, there has a sin that we have to contend with. Well, David battled it. And because of David's turmoil, he was a reproach to his enemies. He was a reproach not only to his enemies, but to his neighbors and to his colleagues. It is one thing to be reproached by your adversaries, by your enemies, and it's easy to know those that don't like you. But it's another thing when your very neighbors turn against you. And it's another thing when your acquaintances turn against you. Yes, David was anointed, but his life was full of trouble. David reached a point in his life where he didn't know who to trust. Because the very friends and colleagues that he had, when he walked the streets, they despised him. The Bible uses the word reproached. And David goes on to talk about his demeanor, how they told lies on him. And those that hated him spread rumors. He calls it slander. Amen. They purposely spoke evil against David and destroyed his character and ruined his reputation. and even Saul. Saul that was rejected by God. Amen. Rejected from the time that David was anointed. But instead of Saul being a mentor to David, Saul became David's most, amen, top enemy. His number one enemy. Saul should have been a mentor to David as he sat on the throne. And it's revelatory because Saul sat on the throne for 20 years but was rejected by God. It's amazing that we can sit in a position but still be rejected by God. And so David had to go through tough times and tough trials. And David had to go through persecution and attack after attack, and his reputation was spoiled. But David, he got to a point where he said, "Woe is me." He regretted the day that he was born. And he looked and said, "God, let these lying lips stop." He said, "God, let these accusers stop." He said, "God, let these that attack me stop." And David reached a point where he was about to say, "I feel like giving up. There is no hope for me." Because David cried and prayed. And it seems that the more that David cried and prayed, the worse his situation became. Have you ever been there? You're praying over something. You're crying out to God. You're fasting. And you're seeking God. And God does not hear you. But God allows your situation to get worse. He allows your enemies to increase. He allows your persecutors to become stronger. But then David gets a revelation in the midst of his complaining, because David had no one to complain to. So he made his complaints to God. Hallelujah. And then finally David gets the revelation. He looks at his situation. He takes his eyes off his condition and then looks to God and says, "How great is our God, and how great is your name." If we can take our thoughts off of what we're going through for a minute, and if we can focus on the goodness of God, if we can focus on what God has done for others in the past. He says that God has goodness laid up as treasures. God is holding back. God has treasures of goodness for you, child of God. God has a measure of goodness to those that fear him, to those that are patient, to those that can hold on right in the midst of your challenge and in the midst of your struggle. Hallelujah. God has goodness in store for you. He says, amen, that God will hide you. David found out, as much as he had a lot of enemies, God would hide him. David found out how to get into the presence of the living God. And when he entered into the presence of God, he says that God hid him there, because no wicked can get into the presence. No evil can get into the presence. As much as you're being slandered, as much as you're being attacked, as long as you're in the presence of the living God, hallelujah, your enemy cannot go there. And so he uses the term secret place. When you worship, when you know how to get into the presence, it is a secret place, because only the fearful, only those that fear God, only those that respect and give reverence to God know how to get to that place. He said in his haste, David was hasty. He was ready to give up. He thought that God had abandoned him. He thought that God had left him. But finally, God heard the cry of David. And David said, "Oh, my people, all of his saints, love God." He said, if you can learn how to love God, take the focus off your problems. Take the focus of your situation, and God will hide you in his pavilion. Focus on God and begin to express love to him. If you love him, all his saints, he will preserve you. God will keep you. No evil shall harm you. No wickedness shall come your way. Just remain faithful to God and allow God to fight your battles for you. For the Bible says that he will reward the proud plentifully. God has an abundance of reward for those that are proud, for those that afflict the righteous, for the wicked that touch the righteous. And God encourages them and says, be of good courage, people of God. Be strengthened. Love God. Keep your focus on God, because he shall strengthen you if you love him. If you preserve, amen. If you're preserved in the arms of God, God will give you strength. He will strengthen your hearts. Hallelujah. All of you that keep your hope in God, don't keep your hope on this earth, because it shall soon pass away. But keep your hope in Jesus. Love God, brethren. Love his commandments. Love his statutes. Walk according to the word of God, and God will give you the plentiful of goodness, the measure of goodness, the treasure of goodness that he has hidden in heaven just for you. If you love him, keep his commandments, and he will preserve you. Heaven bless you. In the name of the Lord Jesus.